Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel here at Kara's Love Techniques. So we are here today talking about the life of the Capricorn male. So before I begin, let me just state that everything that is stated may or may not resonate with your sun or moon rising signs, okay? All right, so let's get started. So here we have our little young Capricorn guy who is generally born at a time where his parents, they have a structured home, but there's some dysfunction there to where they are not at their best. So we may have a mother who's a bit emotionally distant and a father who is overworked and remote from the family. So when he comes into this dynamic, he's usually one of the eldest children and he has to bear a lot of responsibility, especially if it is a single family home. And by that I mean playing the role of a surrogate husband and father to his siblings, setting that example. And ironically, being the sign of the sea goat, you know, as he grows older and becomes a little successful, live well, he actually becomes a scapegoat for his family. So even at his earliest age, he is heavily relied upon by his siblings and his parent or parents. So as a child, our young Cap guy, he is very wise, wise beyond his years, a very old soul. He thinks very conventionally, like, not one of those children who would like to run out and play every day, but kind of just sits back. And he typically does not have the same childhood as many other children would. Coming from a family that's so structured and he has to be, you know, a reliable, responsible brother, he doesn't really get that leisure. So his childhood is kind of taken away from him. He's deprived of that in a sense. But he manages to go through it by reflecting on what his future could be. You know, not a child who would need a great deal of attention from his parents. However, he does remain closer to his mom by default. He would rather be close to his father, who's probably, you know, hard at work, present in the home, but not emotionally there. You know, he wants that influence from a father. He wants to be like his father, you know, have that ambition and drive. However, he doesn't really get that influence from his dad. You know, he really wants to be close to his dad, but he doesn't quite get that as a child. And it's mainly the only attention that he seeks, because this is one of the signs. A Cap man is one of those guys who does not need a whole lot of attention and affection, but he needs to know that he's appreciated and what it is that he's doing in a home. And so as a child, he often reflects on the future. He's thinking about the future, what his life is going to be like, what it is that he's going to do differently from his father and his mom, and the type of household he's going to have. Like, even at the early age of like 7, he's thinking about, hey, when I turn 8, maybe I can go work for Mr. Wilson and help him sell, you know, oranges or whatever. Trying to find ways he can get extra money. And money is always on his mind. That is his driving force, is money, surviving. And as he grows older, he learns how to do that. So ironically, his childhood, you know, having kept him, you know, enclosed in the home and being such, you know, a reliable source in the family, it actually benefits him as he grows older. He learns how to think on his feet. And when he becomes of an adolescent, once again, money on his mind. And these guys are typically athletic. Capricorns are pretty active. You know, football, a sport that shows their competitive nature. Now, Capricorns, unbeknownst to many, are highly competitive people. So if he has a goal and you have that same goal, he's going to do whatever it takes. It means stepping on people to get to that point before you do, so be it. They despise competition, almost fear it, especially when it comes to a woman. And he usually meets one girl, like in high school, mid-teens, that suits his fancy. You know, she's usually someone who's unassuming and unpretentious and innocent, if you will. And he usually takes on to her. But during his mid-teens is when he began to view life as unfair. And he becomes a man who is becoming a man who has certain ideals and beliefs about life. And this is what molds him. However, in the same sense, it makes him a bit melancholy, and he begins to reflect upon his childhood of what could have been and how things should have been, and he may become depressed. And it's at this age is where he begins to fill that void somehow, begin to cope, and is usually through alcohol, which is their biggest weakness. If not alcohol, a very hard drug. However, Capricorn being the preservation sign and the sign of diligence and ambition, regardless their state in life, what they're going through, these people are all functioning, okay? He may be drinking or may be hard on himself at that moment, but I guarantee you, he is trying to achieve something. He's still focused. He's still functioning. They're always functioning, okay? Never, not unlike the Capricorn woman who keeps her hoofs planted firmly on the ground. Well, being the sea goat, he actually falls back. You know, he'll get somewhere in life and then he'll reflect on the past or something that is near and dear to his heart, and he'll fall back. Or he always have moments in his life to where he fall back, but then he bounce back. Because like I said, Capricorns know how to preserve themselves. He'll go become a recluse, you know, go into hiding, bounce back, do it all over again. And then so in his early teens, right before he becomes a full grown man, this is when he realizes, hey, this is the way life is, but this is what I'm going to do. So taking his beliefs and all that it is that he's learned through his childhood, he takes that with him as his means of courage, you know. So he becomes successful very early. This is a man of substance. He knows how to survive, okay? Survivor of the fittest, the Capricorn man is. And he is this way throughout his life. However, even still now, at an older age, and even throughout the rest of his life, he still remains that guy who's heavily relied upon by family, friends, whomever. Everyone always needs him for some reason, and this allows him to retreat, to go back into his shell, to kind of close up, you know. Not a very open guy anyway, but not wanting the burden, but like not also willing to help, you see. And so he find this coming about in his life pretty frequently, but nevertheless, this is a man of diligence. You know, he knows how to survive and maintain and function in life. And he usually is with the same mate or partner throughout the remainder of his life. Considering he may have a few hiccups, he may backslide, you know. This is a sign who's known, the consummate backsliders. Capricorn men, they are. But he knows how to bounce back and make his life full. He live his life full, you know. If it means spending 10 grand on a new television or a piece of jewelry, so be it. He knows when to indulge and he knows when to fall back, okay? But yeah, Capricorn usually have a very intense, full life. And he lives it. And that is all for the Capricorn life. Be certain to check out the Capricorn female next. And until next time.